Hi everyone, my name is Sergio Bedmar and I'm a PhD student at the Estación Biológica de Doñana. This work was developed by Fran Oficialdegui, Miguel Clavero and myself. And the title is Traveling Riverside Blues, Long Distance Migration of the Invasive Atlantic Blue Crab. Well, the Atlantic Blue Crab has a vast native range along the western Atlantic coast, from Canada to Uruguay. Invasive population of blue crab start a rapid expansion along the Mediterranean Sea, the Black Sea, and part of the European Atlantic coast at the beginning of the 21st century. Since then, the invasive blue crab has established very abundant populations, which have been related with a drastic ecosystem alteration, with the declines of native population, as exemplified here. By the green crab in the Ebro Delta, which suffered a collapse after the arrival of the blue crab. You can see in the graph the decline of the blue crab at the point that the blue crab started to increase its abundance. And finally, blue crab invasion has been also related with significant damage to fisheries and their equipments, as you can see in the photos. The life cycle of the blue crab is complex and often involves migration across different habitats with varying water salinities. Mating occurs in upstream environment, either in brackish or freshwater stretches. Then females migrate to the sea to release hatch larvae, and aided by marine currents, the new cohorts returns to the estuaries in the megalopy stage. After the last metamorphosis, juveniles often start an upstream dispersal migration to upper estuaries or riverine stretches where they mature within the next few years. Along its native range, upstream blue crab migration is well known, reaching a stretch more than 250 km from the river mouth. Some examples for river basins where long-distance migration are known include the Mississippi, the Hudson, and also the Apalachicola River Basin in Florida, having this one significant blue crab fisheries in freshwater stretches. However, the potential of the blue crab to penetrate rivers in the embedded range is virtually unknown. Last year, during a sampling campaign focused on freshwater fauna in the Guadalquivir River Basin in southern Spain, we caught several individuals of blue crab more than 100 km from the river mouth, in the Ribera de Huelva, which flow into the Guadalquivir River a few kilometers north from the city of Seville. We extend the sampling to nearby watercourses, aiming to determine the maximum blue crab migration distance in the Guadalquivir River Basin. From 7 to 10 baited fake nets were placed over 24 hours further upstream in Ribera de Huelva, in small tributaries of the Guadalquivir River and in the main Guadalquivir River. In addition, we estimate the probability of occurrence of blue crab as we move upstream from the river mouth. To that time, we compile global records of blue crab occurrence from different sources, obtaining a total of 44,000. Using the Global River Database Hydroset, we select records contained within river basin and exclude marine and coastal records, resulting in about 16,000 inland records in total. Then each record was joined to the nearest river stretch in the Hydro River data layer, and we calculate the distance to the sea of each joined stretch and of all downstream stretch acting as migratory corridor between associated stretch and the sea. Using the density of distance to sea of blue crab records and migratory corridors, we generate an exponential decaying function where the probability of occurrence is 100% at distance zero, decreasing as we move away from the river mouth. We project the Kai function onto the Hydro Rivers data layer for the Iberian Peninsula and the Balearic Islands, and interpreted the probability of blue crab occurrence as a surrogate of its potential impacts. We include stretch freely connected to the sea and exclude all stretch upstream from the dams. Additionally, we estimate the potential blocking effect of dams on blue crab migration. The Iberian range of the critical endangered European eel has been drastically reduced by the effects of dams. Although eels once occupied virtually the entire Iberian Peninsula, today it is confined to just lower stretch of river system. In a similar way as for the blue crab, we calculate the probability of occurrence of the European eel in Iberian rivers and its potential overlap with those of the blue crab. Negative results for blue crab presence were found further upstream in Ribera de Huelva and in small tributaries of the Guadalquivir River. However, we found several individuals in the main Guadalquivir River at 107 km from the river mouth. This finding was just below the Alcalá del Río dam, which stopped the blue crab upstream migration and adds a barrier for migration. And this record supposed the farthest blue crab river migration recorded within its native range. Its native range. Long distance blue crab migration were also reported in other important Iberian rivers. In 2019, I caught a blue crab in the Guadiana River at more than 70 km from the river mouth, while migration at more than 80 km were observed in the Ter River and of more than 60 km in the Ebro River. The probability of occurrence of the blue crab decayed steeply with distance to the sea, dropping to 50% at 19 km, to 25% at 38 km, and to 3% at 100 km. This is the resulting figure from the decaying function projection and illustrates that the potential impact of the blue crab can be particularly severe in lower river systems and coastal streams. But it is still concerning at dozens of kilometers from the river mouth. This figure also showed the compiled blue crab records as red dots and those reported in this study as black dots. Dams act poorly on limiting blue crab river migration, reducing the probability of occurrence by 13% in comparison with a no barrier scenario. The current and artificially reduced probability of occurrence of the European eel overlap with those of the blue crab in the Iberian Peninsula by 63%. Most studies on blue crab invasion focus on coastal and marine ecosystems, but no attention has been paid to its impact on riverine stretch, despite the fact that its migratory capacity is well known. While the probability of occurrence decreases steeply in the first upstream kilometers from the river mouth, it is still concerning at 12 kilometers inland, as reported in several Iberian rivers. As a specialist predator of bivalves, the blue crab is a new threat to freshwater mussels, which population have collapsed in recent decades. It is also a new threat in small coastal streams, often hosting endemic species with a fragile conservation status, such as the Andalusian top carp or the recently described Lodge Cobitis malaria in the south of Cádiz. Although the blocking effect of dams on blue crab migration was very limited, they severely reduce the range of more mobile species, such as the adromorph fish that complete their life cycle between freshwater and marine environments. This is the case of the sea lamprey, of different mugilid species, and especially of the critical endangered European eel which population have declined in 95% since 1980s. As conclusion, our study highlights the need for monitoring the impact of the blue crab in freshwater system, and the diversity and severity of the damage in coastal systems suggests that the blue crab can become a new devastating invader in reachable rivers and streams. Thank you for your attention. Here you can see my contact, and if you can read the complete work, this is the title, and you can and it was published in Aquatic Conservation, Marine and Freshwater Ecosystem, last March. Thank you very much.